Michelle admitted that she relaxes her 3-year-old daughter Rainisha's hair. 3 years old, and she puts chemical straightener on her daughter's hair. Woo, that was like a ton of like, oh my God, emotions and pain and then smiles. And even when she was smiling, it was hurting me. When your daughter is saying, Mommy, it burns, because she has chemicals on her hair and she's 3 years old, what does that make you feel like?
It makes me feel bad, so that's why I choose not to leave it in her hair for that long.
You just do like a quick rinse.
Well, the first time you got a perm in Jalen's hair?
It was back in July, I think.
How old was she?
3. She had turned 3 in June.
Do you like getting perms? I got a little 3-year-old, Zara. She don't have a perm.
My mom started giving me some kitty perms.
So your mama gave you kitty perms? I didn't even know they had kitty perms.
To the drugstore and they see kitty perm. Well, a kitty perm is really the same as any adult perm. It's just milder, but it's still that same chemical, that hydroxide chemical that can be very damaging.
It would be like a kitty beer.
Right, right. Are starting to give their girls, their little girls perms, and they're not even 2 years old yet. They're calling regarding consultation on, Dr. Macklin, what do you think that I should do? My daughter is 1.5, and it's tough for me to comb her hair. I'd really like to put a perm in. What do you think? Under a certain age, the child is still growing, the scalp is still maturing, the follicles are still maturing. And if you're putting this chemical on too early, you're damaging your child's follicles almost for life.
To alter our appearance by changing the texture of our hair is directly linked to self-hate.
Your daughter, Malia, to produce your daughter, you did something to make her how she is. What did you do?
I decided at 11 years old I'd have a baby outside of my race so she'd have better hair.
You decided at 11 years old that you were gonna have
this tease called nappy head, bald headed. So I decided
to have a baby outside of your race. And what race did you decide to have a baby with?
My daughter's half Latino.
She's half Latin. All right. And when you look at children that have hair that is coarser, what does that make you think?
Like me, when I was growing up, low class and poor.
Your daughter was the one that said that kinky your hair is low class.
Yeah.
But she got that from
her
mom.
It's all natural now. Okay. I think it's beautiful.
It's all natural.
So your natural hair is causing a rift with your mother.
Yes. Whenever I cut my hair, because she likes my hair.
So there's a strain on your relationship because of how she's wearing her hair now.
Yes, and it's been a very recent thing that she's decided to go completely natural, and I think it's an adjustment. It doesn't, she doesn't appear like my daughter.
What does that mean, she doesn't appear like your daughter?
It has changed her appearance.
Introducing her to people because of her hair now.
Recently, yes, because of the transition, it's a change in her appearance.
You avoid introducing her to people? I feel, Mom, that you are trying to make it all sound nice.
But it's not nice. I don't think it's necessarily nice, but I do avoid the introductions, and I think that's because I'm adjusting to her.
Adjusting or ashamed?
Because there's a big difference.
Adjusting is, woo, baby, I'm still not used to this hair on you. Let me take a look at it. I might not love it, but here's my daughter. Her name is Tara.
Yeah.
That's adjusting.
Right.
Ashamed is, I'm not going to introduce you. Can you admit that there is some shame?
Well, I think that I'm not going out of my way to make an introduction. And
because you feel people are going to think what when they look at her?
You got a couple other things up in there here. What else she got in there?
Weave.
You have some weave. Doesn't it hurt to get hair tracks sewn up in there? It hurts? How does it make you feel when you don't have weave in your hair?
Happy.
It makes you feel happy when it's not in there.
Yeah.
So then why do you put it there?
She wants it in there.
Whoa. Where's that coming from, Mom? I wasn't expecting that.
Well, she likes it. I mean, she goes to school with her hair done, and everybody compliments her, and she's like on cloud 9.
But she said that she's happy with it out, and it makes you happy.
It looks good. It looks good.
I find it interesting that you're looking at her hair is bad, and that you want it to look more like yours.
I just want it to look nice. I mean, you know, it's easier for me to manage like this.
A weave is not easy, Mama.
it's easier than sitting there for an hour in the morning putting ponytails in. But she's saying that it makes her feel better when it's not there. Do you understand what that does to her self-esteem?
I mean, if she doesn't want it in, she's never told me that. So if she doesn't want it in, then I won't put it in.
Ammonium hydroxide, also known as ammonia water, is a solution of ammonia and water. Much more stronger than the household ammonia, which is diluted, this ammonia can be found in cleaning supplies such as Windex and, not surprisingly, relaxers. Unsealing containers of ammonia hydroxide can lead to a burst in ammonia gas. Sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, phosphoric acid, and ammonia hydroxide are just a few of the harmful ingredients that can be found in the perm. While some chemicals are much harmful than others, as some are used in sodas and even food, these acids combined can be very detrimental to our hair and scalp. Our scalp is no different than our skin. It must be protected. Like our scalp, our skin has pores, and these pores help our body to breathe, so we must protect this skin and treat it with care. Using relaxers is no different to the scalp as to applying acid to the skin. The fact that it burns is not due to consequence.
Man, I'm getting there now. Hold still. Okay, but you're bringing tears, but it's worth it. Oh, man, this stuff is getting there. You might, I can feel it working. Oh, I like that. Let's go. This one, brother, a little word. I'm making it straight. I'm making it straight. You're gonna love this. Oh, ooh, the women, ooh, 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 ooh
You know I'm best in the business.
Oh, just burning just a little bit.
Oh, all right. Man. We almost there.
Man. I don't know if I can take it anymore. Hold on. You better call the fire.
This scene demonstrates what blacks are willing to endure to look like the master. They are willing to risk permanent scars and permanent baldness to disassociate themselves from their natural heritage.
His name was Garrett Augustus Morgan, and he was born the 7th of 11 children of former slaves. He is best known for his invention of the automatic traffic signal and gas mask. But it was around 1910 that he stumbled upon what would become his contribution to the hair care products industry and what would pave the way for several other entrepreneurs and manufacturers over the next 100 years. While working in a sewing machine repair shop, attempting to invent a new lubricating liquid for the machine needle, it is widely believed that Morgan wiped his hands on a wool cloth, returned the next day, found the woolly texture of the cloth had smoothed out, and set out to find how the liquid chemical had changed the texture as it had. He experimented on an Airedale dog, known for their curly textured hair, and the effect was successfully duplicated. Morgan then tried his lubricating liquid invention on himself, called it a hair refining cream, and thus patented the first chemical hair straightener. He founded a personal grooming products company, which included hair dyeing ointments, curved tooth pressing combs, shampoo, hair pressing gloss, and the one that started it all, the G.A. Morgan's hair refiner cream, advertised to positively straighten hair in 15 minutes. Guanidine hydroxide is the other common option of relaxer chemical used today. This is what is referred to as no-lie relaxers. This label can be misleading to consumers. It does not imply that there aren't any strong chemicals used or that the chemicals used are somewhat less potentially damaging. Some have mistakenly thought that with no-lie relaxers, there are less steps and all the worry of chemical hair straightening is removed.
How they make relaxers?
This is a portion of a 7,000 pound batch of relaxers.
7,000 pounds is worth how much?
7,000 pounds, we're talking about $18,000.
This will last Prince about a month.
Exactly.
The slightest little bit of these chemicals can really cause harm to the body. A splash of sodium hydroxide in your eye can potentially lead to blindness. It may not happen right away, but it can lead to blindness later on.
But you eventually have a dog.
Yes, okay. You will eventually have one. And the more of these chemicals you inhale, as you continue to work in it, it can have an adverse effect on your body.
Both lye and no lye relaxers are very strong chemicals that work in the same manner by changing the basic structure of the hair shaft. The chemical penetrates the cortex or cortical layer and loosens the natural curl pattern. This inner layer of the hair shaft is not only what gives curly hair its shape, but provides strength and elasticity. Once this process is performed, it is irreversible. This process, which produces the desired effect of straighter hair, at the same time leaves hair weak and extremely susceptible to breaking and further damage. One must keep in mind that relaxers do not help the hair, but actually strip it. So by applying chemicals to the hair, even if it is to achieve a desired effect, is never really to the benefit of your hair health. Hair breakage, hair thinning, lack of hair growth, scalp irritation or scarring, and hair loss are just some effects as well as complaints of the perm and its users. Most black women with long hair pride themselves in their ability to keep their long hair even after the perm. But what those women don't realize is that that hair started off as a child long, thick, curly, and strong. But after the perm is applied, it may keep its length somewhat, but it becomes thin, weak, and brittle, and bald spots start appearing around the sides as seen.